can you say that you're not responsible? What does it have to do with me? What is my reaction? What should it be? Confronted by this latest atrocity, driven to tears. My comfortable existence is reduced to a shallow, meaningless party. Seems they went so innocent night. All we can offer them was a page in some magazine. Too many cameras and not enough food. This is what we've seen. Driven to tears. love you since I knew you. I would have talked that to you. Talked it once, I won't tell you what. I will share you with another boy. You know my mind is made up. So put your ring on. How are we doing, New Jersey? Let's see some hands, come on now. Called you so many times today. I guess it's all true, but your girlfriend said that you don't ever wanna see me again. Your brother gonna kill me, and he's 6'10". I guess you call it cowardice. I'm not prepared to go on like this. I can't stand losing. I can't stand losing. I can't stand losing you. I can't stand losing you. I can't stand losing you. I see you sent my letters back, my LP records and their eyes crashed. I can't see the point in another day when nobody listened to a word I say. You can call it a lack of confidence. To carry on even doesn't make no sense. I can't stand losing. 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 I'm going to bring our great friend John Mayer to join us. Where are you, John? It's a song called Message in a Bottle. You know this one? Well, we'll just start. Ah, there you go. Give us a count, Andrew.
Yeah! A man who's a bass guitarist, ex-vice president of the United States, a man unafraid of the truth, even if it's inconvenient, Mr. Al Gore!
Thank you for coming to Live Earth. Put all this energy in your heart and help us solve the climate crisis. Good night. God bless.
Music and a powerful environmental message. We're representing the best of both of those here at Giant Stadium are the recently reformed police led by Sting. Well, Sting and his wife, Trudy Styler, co-founded the Rainforest Foundation, and they join us now. Hey, welcome, both of you. You know, you two have been, because of the Rainforest Foundation, been working for this and these issues for decades now. And I imagine seeing this rising fervor for caring about the environment must bring some reaction in you. What about you, Sting?
Well, you know, we've been fighting this struggle for almost 20 years, and it's nice to see that other people are in the struggle too.
But more than nice, it must mean something.
Well, we're away from victory. Well, we can't celebrate too much, you know, but it's great that people are becoming aware of what's happening and trying to do something.
You care so much about the human suffering that what the scientists are predicting will happen. You don't want to have that happen, but you say it's already happening in Ecuador. Tell us what's happening.
I was in Ecuador 3 weeks ago, and what I saw was the most appalling human rights violation I've ever encountered in my 20 years of visiting indigenous groups. Three indigenous groups are fighting for survival because Chevron Oil Company have dumped 18 billion gallons of toxic waste into their lands, poisoning their waters and leaving them with leukemias and cancers three times the rate of anywhere else in Ecuador. And I've met with families, a mum and daughter, mum 38, uterine cancer, daughter 18 years old with liver cancer, who have not a hope, because they took me down to their water supply and I could smell for myself the contamination, smells of oil.
You know, Chevron says that the Ecuadorian oil company is really to blame, and a court is now trying to settle all of this. But you know what? There are heroes involved. There's a man you were pointing out, a young man who's fighting for the rights of the indigenous people. Hero because he doesn't really have a lot of education to really help him do this, and he's fighting against sort of a David and Goliath story. But you know, I think, you know, from just a wonder what it is. I mean, what is it that moved you? We are talking to people now listening about what they should be doing. What moved you? Why do you even care so much?
I care so much because over the years I've been going down a lot and seeing for myself that these people have been living in harmony with their environment, and they should be left to live in harmony with these precious resources, the Amazon rainforest is precious to all of us.
Well, the iron is hot. People are listening. Iron's cool, Sting. So what is the strongest thing you can say tonight to the people listening?
I think we can all make concrete baby steps. Something small is worth doing. I mean, I'm a rock star. I have a pretty heavy global footprint, I admit it. So I have to do something larger, but everybody can do something. Even just turning the lights off. We have a 12-year-old who turns all the lights off in the room, even when people are in it.
I know, they're leading the way, the young
yeah,
people.
Really are.
All right, Sting, Trudy, pleasure. Such a pleasure to
Thank
see you,
you
both.
Thanks.
Be well,
Thanks.
Enjoy. We're really looking forward to hearing you tonight. Oh, come on, stop it. Now let's go to London's Wembley Stadium and the always entertaining Chris.
Do you ever wonder who Roxanne was in that song by The Police, or what really inspired the mega hit Every Breath You Take? Well, now rock legend Sting explains it all in his new book called Lyrics by Sting. Good morning to you.
Good morning
nice to
you.
See you. You always said that you were never going to separate your lyrics from the musical accompaniment. Now, here you do it in this book, and you say in the introduction, gee, it reads suspiciously like a book of poems.
No, it looks like poems.
Okay, there's a difference. Well, did you think you were a poet?
No. I don't think it's poetry. I think they're meant to be sung with music, or said with music. I think poetry is a little more, first of all, most modern poetry doesn't rhyme. The rhythms are more complex. In pop music, everything rhymes, and the rhythm's very simple. So.
But it does provide insight, really, into where you were to different moments in your life as an artist and as a man.
I think, really, that's why I put the book out. I wanted to say where these songs were written, why they were written, what I was singing about, in case anybody was interesting. What on earth is he singing about here?
So they're about songs and lyrics, I think, from about 100 songs here in chronological order. Let's start in 1978 with Roxanne, because that's the song that sort of put you guys on the map when people first heard of Sting and The Police. What inspired that song, and where were you at that point in your life?
I was in Paris, and we were staying in a very cheap hotel in a very seedy part of town, and there were many ladies of the night around there, and I just thought it was very inspiring to me to imagine a relationship with this woman. She wasn't real. I just imagined it.
And it was a good time in your life, though, too. I mean, a city hotel, but you had just started. It's exciting. You were right on the cusp of real fame.
Yeah, I was a young man having a great adventure. But
cut to 1983. A lot happens in those years. A lot of rocky things. Some trouble with the band, personal problems, Every Breath You Take. Started out, it was supposed to be sort of a haunting love song and turned into something else.
It's kind of ambiguous, that song. It is kind of dark, but it is also very seductive. I think that's its power.
The songs, like particularly Roxanne, I guess this one as well, but Roxanne in particular, you say that you will play that night after night, and you still get something out of it. How is that possible? Because I would think after a while it would just be like white noise.
Well, I'm going to sing that song tomorrow night, and I have to sing it with the same passion as if I'd written it that afternoon, the same freshness. And I always find something new in it. Different.
Cut to King of Pain. Now, your wife Trudy was involved in that song also in 1983.
I'm not the King of Pain anymore.
Well, I think she thought you were then.
I was.
Tell us about the lyrics.
I've abdicated. I'm not the King of Pain anymore. I'm the King of Happiness.
But tell us about the lyrics that day.
I think it was a rough time in my life.
Yeah.
You know, it coincided with the most successful period in my life. And that was a big lesson for me. You know, happiness is not about success and money and selling records. It's about something deeper. And that was a great lesson to learn.
And Fields of Gold, that's about home.
It's about continuity. It's about love lasting forever, hopefully.
It's a happy, happy song, really.
It's a sad song, too. But it's also about continuity, about things moving on.
And now you are moving on. 20 years ago, more than 20 since you've been touring with Police.
It's 25.
25 years ago. How is that going?
You know, it seems like the interim has disappeared. It feels like we never stopped.
Really?
We're still the same.
But it's got to be different on tour now than it was back then. You're not quite as wild and crazy, right?
No, it's the same.
Really?
It's exactly the same. I mean, it's fun, and it's enormously successful. And, we're playing tomorrow night at Madison Square Garden, and it's going great.
And are you planning to release a DVD of the tour or anything? What's next for Police?
By the spring, we should have a DVD of the show we put on. We're very proud of the show. I think it's fantastic. It looks great. It sounds great. Yeah.
And now I understand that you have a home in Malibu, and last week you were going to go home and spend a little time there, but you couldn't, right, because of the fires?
They diverted me to the hotel, to a sort of refugee camp. There was very great danger we'd run out of champagne at some point, but the house two doors down was burned, and a lot of people have lost everything, and I feel terrible for them.
Absolutely, unfortunately, for you and your family.
It was pretty smoky down there this week.
And then tomorrow, as you said, you're going to be at Madison Square Garden. You know tomorrow's Halloween. We're expecting a costume.
Okay.
Are you going to be in costume?
Tights.
Tights.
Yeah.
That's it?
And a card piece.
Oh, all right. I'm not even going to pursue this, but is there an extra ticket?
Okay.
Maybe. Before I let you go, having written these lyrics and now looking back over them, what have you learned about yourself through the years? If you can make that kind of a broad, sweeping statement.
I hope I'm maturing.
Yeah.
That's really my intention to do. It's to mature into, middle age, old age, whatever, and just be comfortable in my own skin.
Is there one set of lyrics that really most specifically says who you are?
I like the lyrics of Fields of Gold. They're very simple, but they mean a lot to me. They mean a lot to me.
It's a pleasure to see you. Congrats on the book, too, and on the tour.
Thank you.
And the book is Lyrics by Sting. Thanks very much. And still ahead, lyrics and music, Baby. The Backstreet Boys.